الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. We continue this special program on the scholarly discussion of certain or discussions of certain important matters that require clarification. This second topic is concerning what is referred to in the Quran as al-muhkam, the clear, and al-mutashabih, the unclear verses in the Noble Quran. So the clear and unclear verses, al-muhkam. Muhkam means clear, and mutashabih, not entirely clear. So the question is, what is the muhkam and what is the mutashabih in the Noble Quran, and why the Quran is not all of it clear so that people can interpret it correctly and therefore they can take only the truth and hold to the truth lest they fall into confusion or misconceptions and so forth. The answer: know that the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described it with three descriptions. First, entirely clear, as in the saying of Allah in Surah Yunus chapter 10 verse 1, تلك آيات الكتاب الحكيم. These are the verses of the book full of wisdom and wisdom pertaining to laws information everything. And we read also in Surah Hud 11:1, كِتَابٌ أُحْكِمَتْ آيَاتُهُ. كِتَابٌ أُحْكِمَتْ آيَاتُهُ. There's a lag. This is a book, the verses whereof are perfected in every sphere of knowledge and then explained in detail from one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was always. And then it is described as well that it is mutashabih in the following sense, resembling each other. This is the meaning of the following verse in Surah Az-Zumar 39:23. Allah nazzala ahsan al-hadith kitaban mutashabihan. In Surah Az-Zumar, that's 39:23. Allah has sent down the best statement, the book, its parts resembling each other in goodness and truth, oft repeated. This is the meaning of متشابه in this verse. And this is general, covers the entire Quran. So the general ruling regarding the entire Quran is that it is muhkam, muttaqan, it is full of wisdom, perfected in its news, in its rules, laws, in its words, and so forth. And it is also mutashabih in the sense that its parts resemble each other in perfection and in goodness and in truthfulness and in agreement. And that's why we don't find in the Quran rules that are contradictory or information that are contradictory, rather each part testifying for the other in truthfulness. However, it requires pondering and contemplation concerning the verses, whereby there may appear to the person may appear some contradiction therein. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa 4:82, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. Do they not consider the Quran carefully and ponder on it? Had it been from other than Allah, they would surely have found therein much contradictions. So now, two descriptions came up. Perfection, full of wisdom, resembling each other in goodness, its parts, and in clarity, and in confirming and attestation in truthfulness and good, oft repeated. The third description is that some of its verses, some of it is muhkam, entirely clear, some of it is mutashabih, not entirely clear. As in 7, as in Al Imran 3:7, هو الذي أنزل عليك الكتاب منه آيات محكمات هن أم الكتاب وأخر متشابهات. Some of these verses. But there we read متشابه concerning the book. In the earlier description, in the second description, the entire book, its parts resemble each other in goodness and etc. Here about the verses. Okay, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, it is He who has sent down to you the book. In it are verses that are entirely clear, and they are the foundations of the book. Remember this statement. And others not entirely clear. Okay. So, what is the muhkam? A muhkam, now you know, it means entirely clear. Zahir, apparently clear. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, in contrast, that there are verses which, أُخَرُ مُتَشَابِهَات, others are not entirely clear. And here you know, therefore, since Allah mentioned that there are verses that are not entirely clear, then you conclude that the other ones are clear. And this is a very important foundation in tafsir of the Quran, in the sense that the interpretation of a word may be known by the linked word which could be having an opposite meaning, or in contrast, it comes in the text in a contrast format. This is a good foundation in tafsir. So this foundation will tell us that the meaning of a certain word may be deducted from the other contrast which may follow or which may come before. Like take for example in Surah An-Nisa 4:71, فَانْفِرُوا ثُبَاتٍ أَوْ انْفِرُوا جَمِيعًا. Or you believe, take your precautions and either go forth, thubat. Okay, Allah used go forth here, thubat, or go forth, jami'a. Or go forth altogether. So from the word jami'an, which means altogether, we can know that thubat, which came before, it would mean in parties, not as groups, individuals. So this is an example. Similarly, in the verse which we are dealing with, which is 3:7, when we said, from it are verses which are muhkamat, they are the foundation of the book, and others are mutashabih, not entirely clear. So we know from this that the muhkam is entirely clear. Its meaning is very clear, no unclarity whatsoever, because, and thus it becomes known to the common and to the particular of people. Like for example, when Allah says, وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُ الزَّكَاةَ, and establish salah and give charity. The due charity. So it is known, this is known for the common Muslim, for the learned, and for the, you know, senior seeker of knowledge, or one who's just starting, for the scholar, for the common Muslim, and it's known for everyone. And there are other verses, not entirely clear, whose meaning is unknown to many people, known only to Allah and to those who are firmly established in knowledge. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the same verse, in it are verses that not are entirely clear, they are the foundations of the book, and others not entirely clear, mutashabih. Now let us have the continuity of the verse. فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ زَيْغٌ, as for those who have deviation in their hearts, فَيَتَّبِعُونَ مَا تَشَابَهَ مِنْهِ, they follow that which is mutashabih, not entirely clear. ابتغاء الفتنة, seeking فتنة, discord and disputes and mischief. وابتغاء تأويله. Can we have the verse, please? So as for those in whose hearts there is deviation from the truth, they follow that which is not entirely clear thereof, seeking fitna, trials, afflictions, and seeking for its hidden meanings. But none knows its hidden meaning save Allah. Save Allah. Now here, I want your attention. Save Allah. And there are two recitations. One is to stop at Allah here, at the term Allah. And the other is to continue, non-stop. So you read, but none knows its hidden meaning save Allah and those who are firmly grounded in knowledge. Meaning those, if you continue the recitation, this is another recitation of this verse, then Allah and those who are firmly established in knowledge know the meaning. So this is the meaning of the muhkam and the mutashabih, and we know that therefore the people of deviation, they follow the mutashabih. And this is people who have witnessed over the past year in this room, almost I think we have finished the year, alhamdulillah, have seen some examples of some people who come here and they follow the mutashabih, they bring that which is not entirely clear, trying to make an issue and seek a fitna. Now to the other part of the question is, what is the wisdom that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't make the Quran entirely clear, rather made some of it mutashabih, not entirely clear. The answer to this is from two angles. First angle is that the Quran in its entirety is muhkam, is clear in the general sense. And this came in the very early in the introduction to our talk. Even in this verse which we are referring to, if we take that, please give me your attention. Now give me ones, please give me ones, so that I know that this point inshallah is reaching you. طيب الحمد لله. Even concerning this verse, if we take that which is not entirely clear, if we refer it to the entirely clear, then the meaning becomes clear, and thus everything becomes muhkam, everything becomes entirely clear. Is this understood? Is this angle and response clear to you? Or shall I repeat it? Yes, inshallah. Okay, we'll repeat. If you take this verse which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمِنْهُ آيَاتٌ مُحْكَمَاتٌ, and from it there are clear verses, هُنَّ أُمُّ الْكِتَابِ, they are the mother, the foundation of the book, and others not entirely clear. So if we take these which are not entirely clear, and we refer them, and if we refer them to those that are entirely clear, then everything will become clear. And this is the way of those who are firmly established in knowledge. They take that which is not entirely clear, they refer it to that which constitutes the foundation of the book, those which are entirely clear foundations, and therefore anything that is unclear becomes clear, and from this we know therefore that the entire Quran is clear. Now is that now clear to you inshallah? I try to simplify it as much as possible. Okay. So unlike the people who have deviation in their hearts, they follow that which is not entirely clear. They don't take the entirely that which is mutashabih. They don't take it to that which is muhkam, which is entirely clear, and thus it becomes clear. No, rather they stick to that which is not entirely clear because of deviation in their hearts, and because they seek fitna, as Allah spoke of them. Is that clear now, sister Diamond? You wanted me to repeat that. Is that clear, inshallah? This angle, this response. Somewhat. A verse which is not entirely clear is called mutashabih, and there are other verses in the Quran which are entirely clear. They are the foundations of the book. So you take these things which are not entirely clear, refer them to those which are entirely clear, everything becomes clear, and therefore the Quran as a whole is all muhkam, all entirely clear. The second angle of the response is to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put this mutashabih, this which is not entirely clear, which requires pondering and referral to that which is entirely clear, he put that due to a wisdom, and this wisdom is testing and trials. So those people who take by these mutashabih as a means for fitna and to cast doubts concerning the Quran, this becomes a fitna and a trial for them, a testing. And you know, testing also takes place in the rulings or in the verses, like in the Quran. Similarly, in the universal decrees of Allah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may ordain some things as tests for man in his applicability, in his application of Sharia. Think, and we discussed this just the other day, think what Allah tested the Jews concerning the Sabbath and the fishing, when Allah forbade them to fish on Saturday. Allah tested them by bringing the fish quite in the open on the surface of water on Saturday, and other than Saturday nothing comes out. So because they didn't persevere, they were not patient on this trial, they resorted to, anyone tells me, someone tells me now from those who are attending the classes, alhamdulillah, what did they resort to? Putting their nets when? Put the net on Friday, so that it can catch the fish, and then take it off on Sunday. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them on this. Also consider the test and the trial which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala subjected the Sahaba, the companions, to. In Surah Al-Ma'idah 5:92, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَيَبْلُوَنَّكُمُ اللَّهُ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الصَّيْدِ تَنَالُهُ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَرِمَاحُكُمْ لِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَخَافُهُ بِالْغَيْبِ. Allah now is testing or tested the companions, making the hunting easy to for them while they are in a state of ihram, while they were in a state of ihram. All you who believe, kill not the game while you are in a state of ihram for, you know, for Hajj or Umrah. And whoever of you kills it intentionally, the penalty is an offering brought to the Kaaba of an eatable animal, equivalent to the one he killed, as judged by two just men among you, or for expiation he should feed poor persons, or its equivalent in fasting, that he may taste the heaviness of punishment of his deed. Allah has forgiven what is past, but whoever commits it again, Allah will take retribution for him, and Allah is almighty, all able of retribution. So there was the easy game for them while they were in ihram, so they were patient. They didn't do anything unlawful from what Allah forbade. Similarly, these revelations, the verses, which may contain something which is not entirely clear, and which may appear quote unquote contradictory, belying each other, similarly, this could be a trial for people. However, those who are affirmed in knowledge, firmly established in knowledge, know how reconcile between these verses and thus deduce the correct meaning. As for the people of fitna and affliction and evil, they take from this a path to make the Quran as if it is contradictory. As Allah spoke about them, فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ زَيْغٌ, as for those who is in his heart or who is in their hearts there is deviation, فَيَتَّبِعُونَ مَا تَشَابَهَ مِنْهُ, they follow that which is not entirely clear thereof, seeking fitna and seeking for its hidden meanings, but none knows its hidden meanings save Allah and those who are firmly established in knowledge according to one recitation. والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. This answer that you heard came